हाय एवरीवन, दिस इज सन्नी कुमार फ्रॉम मैथमेटिक्स एंड कंप्यूटिंग पार्ट टू फ्रॉम IIT BHU एंड टुडे आई एम बैक अगेन विथ अनदर वीडियो ऑफ एट कोडर बिगिनर कॉन्टेस्ट 190। सो लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन। वेरी वेरी प्रिमिटिव गेम। सो बेसिकली इन दिस क्वेश्चन वी हैव बीन गिवन टू प्लेयर्स, तकाहाशी एंड एओकी। बोथ आर प्लेइंग अल्टरनेटली एंड बोथ हैव सम सर्टेन नंबर ऑफ कैंडीज A and B. A will denote the Takahashi number. Takahashi has some candies and B will denote the Aoki's. So if C is 0, Takahashi will start the game. Otherwise, Aoki will start the game. And the person who is unable to do the operation will lose. And we have to determine the winner of the game. So let's understand this question some mathematically. So basically, we have been given C. If C is 0, Takahashi will start the game. And if A is greater than B, it means if Takahashi will have more number of candies than Aoki, then it is obvious that Aoki has candies B will be exhausted before the Takahashi's if they both play alternately. And in this case, if A is greater than B, then Takahashi will surely win, otherwise Aoki will win. And in the other case, if C is equal to 1, then if B is greater than A, it means if Aoki has more number of candies, that is Aoki will start the game, and it has more number of candies, strictly more, then Aoki will obviously win because Takahashi's candies will be exhausted before the game, so Takahashi will lose otherwise. So if B is greater than A, Aoki will win, otherwise Takahashi will win. So the question is very simple. So let's move on to the code section of the video. Now here I have taken A, B, C. And if C is 0, and again if A is greater than B, it means Takahashi's candies has more than Aoki's candies, then Takahashi will surely win, otherwise Aoki will win. And in if C is equal to 1, and if Aoki's candies is more than Takahashi's candies, it means Takahashi's candies will be exhausted before Aoki's candies, so Aoki candies will be left, so Aoki will win in this case, otherwise in this case Takahashi will win. So the question is very simple. So let's move on to the second question. Okay. Now the second question is magic 3. So basically in this question, we have been given Takahashi, a magician, and he can use any spells according to the question. And ith spell denotes two integers. First integer denotes xi, which is the time taken to cast the spell, that is to time taken to cast the ith spell, and second integer yi will denote the power of the ith spell. So basically Takahashi, we have to report yes or no. We have to print yes if Takahashi can damage the monster, otherwise we have to print no, that Takahashi cannot damage the monster. Now the how to damage a monster, there is a condition that is given in the question. The monster is strong enough to avoid taking damage from spells taking s or more seconds to cast and spells with power d or less. So if the ith spell has power strictly less than s, and sorry, if the ith spell has power yi which is strictly more than d, or and it takes xi seconds to cast and xi is strictly less than s, then we can say that the monster can damage the Takahashi. And the question is very simple. So let's move on to the code section of the video. Now in this you can see here n denotes the number of spells and s denotes the maximum time to cast the ith spell, that is monster is strong enough to avoid taking damage from spells taking s. So s denotes here the capital S value and d is the power. So for each ith spell, that is for each spell, we have to check if a is less than s, that is for the ith spell, if it takes strictly less than s seconds to cast the ith spell and strictly more power then the power to destroy the monster, that is small d, and if a is strictly less than s and b is strictly more than d, then we can say that yes, there exists an answer, yes, and sorry, there exists a spell which can destroy the monster. So I am going to make this boolean variable as true, and if finally after checking for all the spells, if boo is true, that is if boolean value is true, then we can say that yes, monster can destroy the, sorry, the ith spell can destroy the monster. Otherwise, we have to print no. So the question is very simple. As question is actually of implementation part. So if you have any doubts in both the questions, do mention in the comment section of the video, and I'll ask the viewers to like this video, share this video, and join our Telegram channel as mentioned in the description section of the video. Thank you for watching this video.